Then question number 6, they have already given us an equation. This is a given linear equation in two variables. 2x plus 3y minus 8 is 0. And the question is, write another linear equation in two variables such that the geometric representation has got intersecting lines, parallel lines, and coincident lines. So let's take one by one. So first, concentrate on what is given. 2x plus 3y minus 8 is 0. We need intersecting lines. So if the lines are intersecting, that means the solution has to be unique. Okay? If the lines are intersecting, the solution has to be unique. So you remember the condition for unique? The condition for unique is a1 by a2 should not be equal to b1 by b2. That means I can write down any equation where when I compare a1 by a2 and b1 by b2, then a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 should not be equal to each other. Okay, so this is one example. There are infinite examples. Okay, so I have written a1 by a2 here. This is what? 2 by 4. The ratio is 1 by 2. And here I have written 3 by 5. Okay, I have written 5 here. So obviously a1 by a2 and b1 by b2 are not equal. So you need to write any equation which satisfies this condition that the coefficient of x's here, that is a1 by a2, should not be equal to the coefficients of ratio of coefficient of y. So a1 by a2 not equal to b1 by b2. So this is an example of the first part where this will be when you solve this and or if you plot this on a graph, you are going to get intersecting lines. Then the second part is we need parallel lines. So parallel lines means what? No solution. Parallel lines means no solution. And condition for no solution, you remember a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 not equal to c1 by c2. So now these two are equal. So I'm going to select a suitable equation. I have made this as 4x plus 6y minus 15 because a1 by a2, 2 by 4 will become 1 by 2. b1 by b2, that is 3 by 6 is also 1 by 2. So you need to select same. Okay, it could be any ratio, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, that's up to you. So I have made this also 1 by 2, this is also 1 by 2 because 2 by 4 is 1 by 2, 3 by 6 is also 1 by 2. But when I look at the third term, this is 8 and this is 15, this is certainly not 1 by 2. So I have satisfied this condition. So this will be the required answer here. So when I solve these two lines, these two equations on a graph, I'm going to get parallel lines. Or if I solve this algebraically, I won't get any solution. Then the third part is coincident lines. Coincident lines happens when we have infinitely many solutions. Okay. And what is the condition? A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2 all are equal to each other. So I will choose an equation where the ratio of A1, that is 2, and here 4. So the ratio here is 1 by 2. Then I'm looking at b1 by b2. So that is 3 by 6. That is also 1 by 2. And I have put minus 8 and minus 16. So that is also 1 by 2. Okay. So all of them are equal. So you can write any equation like this. I have just given you an example. But this is not a fixed answer. Answers can vary. The only thing is that the equations should be written in such a manner that these conditions are satisfied. Okay, so you need to satisfy the conditions. So this is how we do this question number 6.